Hello, my name is Elif. I make anatomy and medicine videos. If you like my videos, please subscribe my YouTube channel and follow me on my Instagram and Facebook pages. Hello, in this video, I will talk about external anatomy of medulla oblongata from dorsal aspect. On the posterior surface of the medulla oblongata, there is dorsal median sulcus on the midline. It is also known as sulcus medianus posterior in Latin. This groove is the same groove in the spinal cord which continues above. On the posterior lateral side, the posterior lateral sulcus extends. This sulcus is also known as sulcus posterior lateralis in Latin. Between the posterior median sulcus and sulcus posterior lateralis, there is posterior intermediate sulcus. This is also known as sulcus intermedius posterior in Latin.
Posterior intermediate sulcus divides the funiculus posterior into two below. From this division, the inner division is called as gracile fascicle. Gracile fascicle is referred as fasciculus gracilis in Latin, and gracile means slender. The outer division is called as cuneate fascicle. Cuneate fascicle is referred as fasciculus cuneatus in Latin. Cuneatus means wedge. These fascicles terminate above as tubercles. Fasciculus gracilis terminates as gracile tubercle. Gracile tubercle is known as tuberculum gracili. Fasciculus cuneatus terminates as cuneate tubercle, which known as tuberculum cuneatum in Latin.
Lateral to each cuneate nucleus, there are prominences which called as trigeminal tubercle. It is also known as tuberculum trigeminale or tuberculum sinerum. Trigeminal tubercle is formed by the spinal nucleus of trigeminal nerve. It is also known as nucleus spinalis nervi trigemini, which is a fifth cranial nerve nucleus. There is a transverse medullary layer where the posterior median sulcus terminates and the central canal opens into the fourth ventricle. This structure known as the orbex.